Rolling, 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 rolling. Yeah! Yeah! Keep rolling, 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 though the streams are swollen. Oh, hello. I'm Betty St. Laveau. Welcome to Celluloid Mirror. How are you doing today? We have a jam-packed show for you all. This is Katie Segal, part two. And I have named this episode that because I think that we stopped off at Katie Segal, part one. First, I want to go through some acknowledgments because it's almost been 20 years since I started doing this show. I started with Kenrick over at Adelphia. In the middle, I had Tony over at Mad River Valley TV, and now we have Zach, Rob, Jen, Chris, Brett, and the gang here at Orca. I really want to thank them so much for indulging me in talking about movies the past two decades, number one. Number two, I want to talk about some great content creators that I've been checking out on YouTube this past year. They've been kind of blowing me mind. They all have different types of subjects, so I'm just going to name some off, say what they do, and then maybe you all can check them out and enjoy them also. The first two are my favorite crime guys, Briefcase and Crime Reel. We then have Live Abuse Free by an excellent psychoanalyst who lives far away. She gives us tips about living abuse free. Then we have Dr. Grande, who does analysis of all types of celebrities and regular people. Jim Can't Swim is another crime library channel. LPR Presents is also another excellent one. Briefcase and Crime Reel, there are British cousins, and then everybody else is American. Oh, and Live Abuse Free is our cousin also. Then, when it comes to my MMA guys, we have Kenan KTV. He's a very good professor of mine. Alpaca Thesaurus, but he's more on Twitter lately, I think. The one and only Chael Sonnen, who is so adorable. Mind Smash, Submission Radio, and I think that's about it. So please check out these excellent YouTube content creators, their shows are excellent. The content and the production values can't be beat. Okay, so now let's go into some movies. All right, so let's see, where are we going to start? I think we're going to start off in charming California, Kurt Sutter's beautiful town where he created all of these interesting characters on his show, Sons of Anarchy. This is a show that, thanks to Kellogg Hubbard Library, having the first season, and it was one of the last days of a book sale, I grabbed it for maybe a dollar. It took me a week probably to watch it, and then as I'm checking out the show, the very first episode, I see on their motorcycles Kim Coates, Ron Perlman, Mark Boone Jr., and Tommy Flanagan. Well known to me by the other shows and movies that they've been in. So I sort of set the DVD down again because, oh, I know those actors, they're not going to be believable to me. By the eighth episode or the seventh episode, I was pretty much hooked. Kurt Sutter is a genius. His wife, Katie Segal, is a beautiful muse. I can't say enough about the show. I finally decided that I was going to write a paper called The Myth of the American West, The Rise of Motorcycle Culture, and The Maternal Instinct, Kurt Sutter's Gemma and Jax Teller. So maybe one day the paper will be published. At any rate, the casting of the show, the talent, it seems everybody had a guest part. Hal Holbrook, Courtney Love, David Hasselhoff, Michael Chilkis, Walter Goggins, you name it, they were on it. And also, the Walter Goggins and Michael Chilkis actually showing up on the show. I did a rough draft of a spreadsheet of Sons of Anarchy. Let's see, what's my default? Sons of Anarchy, Justified, Deadwood's my default, and what's the third one? American Horror Story. FX, during the first part of this century, literally this century, they were knocking out excellent television shows, actors, producers, camera persons, etc. And I wish that I had checked out these shows when they had first aired, but I'm always 10 or 15 minutes late when it comes to pop culture. At any rate, let's go over some of the people who were cast for the excellent Sons of Anarchy. Ron Yoon, Matthew St. Patrick, Ron Yoon, Matthew St. Patrick, Hal Holbrook, Jose Pablo Cantillo, Robin Weigart, Malcolm Jamal Warner, Courtney Love, Titus Welliver, Belima Logan, Winter Avizzoli, Kenneth Choi, Kim Dickens, Wanda DeJesus, Michael Ormstein, I'm missing his middle name. Sorry about that, Mr. Michael. Mitch Pileggi, Kiaanaka Kilcha, Deirdre Taylor, Billy Brown August, Harold Perrineau, Ali Walker, Taryn Manning, Taylor Sheridan, Glenn Puma. Adam Alkin, who not only played a villain on the show, he produced it. Alan Colt, that's the director's list. I don't want to forget Ryan Hurst, Jimmy Smits, Maggie Seth, Dayton Kelly, Drea D'Amato, Kim Coates, Charlie Hunan, Katie Sagal, and I'm missing one other person, Jimmy Smits. My man. All right, so it ran six or seven seasons. Mr. Sutter was born May 6, 1960. He was educated at Rutgers University, Northern Illinois University, and moved to L.A. in 2000. He was a staff writer on the first season of The Shield, wrote many excellent episodes for that, and on Sons of Anarchy, he played Otto Delaney, who was a member of the Sons, incarcerated in jail. Mr. Sutter, my hat is off to you. Not only did you produce and create this excellent show, Otto is a multifaceted character. You are a genius. Right on. Okay, right on. So, because I'm going through this kind of quickly, we might do a Katie Sagal part three. I want to go into Gemma's psychology a little bit, but not too much. Her character is extremely complex, and she has many sides to her, let's just put it like that. Okay, so I'm done with Kurt for a minute, but we'll get back to him, I think, in future episodes, because when Gloria Swanson starred in Sunset Boulevard, the story is about a washed-up movie star who lives in her own dream world. At any rate, I believe she got an Academy Award for that, but at the screening of that movie, it was either Mary Pickford or Claudette Colbert. But after the screening, Swanson had been in her 40s. At that time in Hollywood, actresses were washed up. One of the actresses came over and kissed the hem of her dress. I would totally kiss the hem of Kurt Sutter's suit if I could. Thank you, Mr. Sutter. Okay, so now another show that I discovered FX-wise all this time, while I've been checking out other medium than movies, is American Horror Story. The first episode, and I remember back in the day, I tried to watch the first episode when it came on. I'm like, it's not going to be okay. And then I attempted to watch the second episode, And because I could see that the violence was about to appear, it's called American Horror Story. What was I thinking? I shelved it, put it away. So for some reason, and I remember this, one of my nieces, she's adorable. She's asked me to check it out. Just like with Sons of Anarchy, by the eighth episode, I was laughing at all the ghosts bitching at one another. I thought it was the funniest thing. So I'm not going to do Asylum or Freak Show. I can't go there. But I started watching the 1984 one. The colors are hysterical. Whoever is designing the costumes and the set, right on, okay? I've only watched a couple episodes. I'm not really into stories or TV, the medium television that uses past figures from the past to tell a story. And they do that in this particular season, but I might get past that. I've only watched a few episodes. At any rate, please check it out. It's very chilling. Again, a great cast, and some of the actors that you see on the show have shown up in other FX shows. Okay. And we'll go back into that at some other point. I just wanted to point out that the show's awesome. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be. So here's my draft of my spreadsheet showing the actors on one list, and then Justified, Sons of Anarchy, American Horror Story, and The Default, Deadwood, showing who they played. And I'll work on that some more, but I like that project, makes me kind of excited. Okay, so the next show I want to talk about, FX again, is Justified, and that's Elmore Leonard's opus, Chip Villeluch, and I can't remember Ryan's last name, sorry. They created American Horror Story. Mr. Graham Yost developed Justified from Elmore Leonard's story, book, Fire in the Hole, featuring Raylan Givens. Again, we have an excellent cast. This show ran for 6 seasons. They did it perfectly. And again, the guest stars are incredible. Eric Roberts, Mary Steenburgen, Sam Elliott, Max Perlich, Eddie Gathegi, John Kaplos, Amy Smalt, Jeff Fahey, Alicia Witt, and Erica Taisel, David Mayonnaise, Nick Sacy, Joelle Carter, Jeremy Davis, and who plays Raylan's sidekick there? At any rate, Raymond J. Barry, what a cast. Just an excellent, Jacob Pitts, pardon me, plays Tim. Jer Burns. Justified is a show about Raylan Givens, a U.S. Marshal who's a good lawman, but he's not such a good marshal. He does things that he really probably shouldn't, but there's a lot of, what do you call it, when things are rectified, there's conflict resolution, if not in the episode, towards the end of the season. And Raylan is a complex character in some ways. He leaves Kentucky, goes to work for the Marshal Services in Miami, gets into a spot of trouble, which is akin to his nature, and then is sent home back to Harlan County, where he runs up against old friends and sometimes makes some new ones, sometimes not. At any rate, Justified is near and dear to my heart. One of my great grandmas came out of Kentucky. So please check that out. All right, so now that we've caught up with some of the YouTube television viewing that I've been snacking on, I want to go, should I go to the cons of Bollywood? I want to discuss the fact that Bollywood, which is in India, state of mind. It's just like Hollywood, but the stars are even more famous than the stars here. For instance, my man Shah Rukhsan, he is more famous worldwide than Tom Cruise and possibly even my man the Fresh Prince of Bel Air there, okay? He has several, I mean, he has probably a few dozen honorary doctorates, and he began his career in the television late 1980s. He is one of three actors who are called the Khans of Bollywood, and it refers to not just the three top actors, but several actors from their Mumbai-based Hindi language in the Indian film industry. The three Khans are Salman Khan, Shahrukh Khan, and Aamir Khan. Pardon me, I'm not very good at pronouncing these names, so I'm gonna get better at it. So I just wanted to point out the fact that even though we have this industry here, there is Bollywood in India, and there's Nollywood in Nigeria. And I think that before I go into more about Shahrukh Khan, who is the most famous man and one of the most powerful people in the world, and the Khans of Bollywood, I'll do a little bit more research on Bollywood, because some of these stars that I'm talking about, and I'm remembering this as I'm sitting here, they come from movie star dynasties. Not Mr. Shah Zahn here, but a few of the ones that I'm talking about, and I think I probably should go into the movies that their parents did also, just before I go in. I've got, most of this is bibliography right here, but I've got quite a bit of information. One of the reasons why I wanted to check out Bollywood is because years ago, I watched my first Bollywood movie. I was in Philadelphia visiting one of my sisters, and I remember how I caught it towards the end, and some violence happened. It wasn't like American violence, but some violence happened. A couple guys started tussling around, and the music behind it sounded kind of cheery, and it reminded me of watching Rich and Famous with Chow Yun-fat, which I actually own. So I can't remember what movie that was. I bet I could hunt it down. Because of my interest in that movie, I started to do some cross-referencing, and I came upon Sanhye Dutt, who is actually my first Bollywood movie star that I ever did some research on. And all these Khans here, that the three Khans, well, Dutt isn't one of the Khans, but these men are all born around the same time that Mr. Dutt was born, 1959, 1960, etc. So instead of going in depth, all I want to do is talk about how famous this gentleman is. But maybe I should just check out some of his movies on YouTube first and bring you essay or dissertation on a movie that I've seen of his, because also I feel a little shy. Bollywood is not like Hollywood, and I don't mean that as it's more intimidating as a research project, but I don't know that much about it, but I'm glad that I brought this information today just to kind of play off of. Yeah, and not only will we discuss Bollywood on this show in the Three Khans, you can catch this on St. Lavoe's World Cinema at some point, where I will definitely go into the genealogy of these famous Bollywood movie stars. All right, so just to sum that up, Shahrukh Khan, Aamir Khan, and Salman Khan are the three most famous Bollywood movie stars, but there's also Dilip Kumar, Saif Ali Khan, and Irfan Khan, and sadly enough, he passed away a couple of years ago. All right, and he was in a Spider-Man movie. I glanced at that last night. Okay, so the last subject that we're going to talk about today is Terrence Malick's beautiful Days of Heaven, made in 1978, starring Richard Gere, Brooke Adams, and Linda Mance. Sam Shepard also. What a beautiful movie. It's one of the most beautiful movies ever made. One of my favorite producers in my heart, Bert Schneider and his brother Harold Schneider, they produced it, and Terrence directed it. And the budget was $3 million. Bert helped out the production with his own money, and the movie only made it didn't make a dime. It made maybe, I don't know, I want to say $50 million, $50,000. No, it made $500,000. But the fact that it was shot for $3 million and then grossed $3.5 million, it took a loss. And I don't understand why, but we're on the eve of Star Wars. You know, we've got lipstick, we've got shampoo, we've got frothy romances, we've got some new Hollywood stuff going on. Maybe Days of Heaven just wasn't people's cup of tea. But it was set with, it was shot with natural light, very naturalistic. There wasn't any studio lighting. I don't mean to space out, but I just recently rewatched the movie the other night. People complained about the plot. Who cares about the plot? The music, the movie's so stunning and beautiful. Just sit back and enjoy the show. We have Richard Gere, Brooke Adams, and Richard Gere's little sister leaving Chicago to go work in the Texas Panhandle for the rich farmer who is Sam Shepard. Hijinks ensue, some of them not all that pretty. There's this translation of what I call the silence and beauty of nature that Mr. Malick was able to translate and give to us. So please check it out. Doesn't cost hardly anything on YouTube. The music was by Ennio Morricone, one of my favorite composers, and Leo Kottke. The cinematography was both done by Nestor Almendros and Haskell Wexler, who shot basically half the movie, just to let you all know. And distributed by Paramount Pictures. The running time is 94 minutes. And among the rest of the cast were Robert J. Wilkie, Jackie Schultes, Stuart Margolin, Timothy Scott, Gene Bell, Doug Kershaw, and Richard Libertini. Yes, and I can't remember if I ever touched on this show. The last 2 years, I might have. My last two shows here were shot accidentally without volume, but if I have talked about this movie before, pardon, who can blame me? What a great, great, just a feast for the eyes, feast for the senses. Narrated largely by Ms. Linda Mance, who helped the continuity flow. All right, so is that it? I think that's all for us today. I'm your hostess, Betty St. Laveau. So nice to see you all after a long time. With the acknowledgments that I started beforehand, I'd also like to thank, amongst others, let me get to my list here. I'm trying to do it on the sly, but it doesn't look like I can find it. Oh, it's right here. Okay, so not only do I want to thank past and present directors and producers of the show, I want to thank Lowell Smith, who owned Capitol Video years ago and erased many of my movie fees. Thank you, Lowell. Bless your heart. Kellogg Hubbard Library, of course. Hitchcock and Federico Fellini, I better thank them. And I've got a list of others here, but you all are going to be like, she's really going off and sort of spacing out everybody that she has to thank. But it takes a lot to make a movie. I think of all the gaffers and electricians that I haven't given a shout out to, because movies, to make a movie and even a television show, sometimes it's thousands of people. It's not just one person. So when you all are looking at a movie that you don't like and you're kind of making fun of it, remember that there's a reason why it's bad, but there's a reason why it was made, because people are crazy about movies and they want to make movies. Right on. Okay, so you all take care, and to Sharon, Ardella Walfield, Paris Ochesanya Klarich, once again, my first film professor, my mom, thank you for helping me appreciate and articulate my way to explaining about my love of movies. Until next time, darlings, ciao.